This episode of Rolled Up is brought to you by Deuce Fight Company and Studio 540. I'm an avid traveler, co-founder of BudoVideos.com, jiu-jitsu black belt, and lifelong student of the martial arts, who strives to know more about the competitors and instructors who are revolutionizing the jiu-jitsu lifestyle. Join me in my journey as I travel, train, learn, and get rolled up. His is a story of redemption, the story of an athlete and a champion that came from the most unexpected of places. Using his charm, athleticism, and natural talent, Fernando Tadede literally fought his way into the jiu-jitsu world. Originating from the Cantagalo favela, overlooking beautiful Rio de Janeiro, he was the first of many favela kids to make his way onto the BJJ scene and capture not one, but two jiu-jitsu world titles. With many unforgettable matches with the likes of Roger Gracie, Fabricio Verdum, Jacare, Nino Chambry, and Marcelo Garcia, Tadede has solidified himself as one of the most decorated, entertaining, and influential competitors of all time. His innovative approach to jiu-jitsu still resonates today, and Cobrinha, Andre Galvao, and many others also call him professor. Much of what we now call modern jiu-jitsu originated with this man.
And the first time that I met Tadede was many years ago, when he was like a boy. Little boy, and I met him many times before when he had just in the street and take care about the cars there, and look him many times. Okay, he's always a smart guy. I can see that his eyes, okay, a smart guy always. And the one guy that worked with me there, like Tavinho, Otávio, Couto, Ratinho, nickname. They always talk him, and invite him to come at the academy to train first time, and talk to me. Oh, Gigi. Maybe he can train one day here, okay?
Okay.
Good, nice guy, looks like a very good guy. And the first training, I couldn't see that he's a very good talent. Maybe smart and good education is important. You never know about people that put under the other guys, okay? And step by step, he started to build his place there, understand? With good education, good sparring, to always like to be like smart, to train better as possible, and look for to compete more as possible, always, much more than other guys. Every week, and almost, he like to compete, almost.
Alan Santiago is a jiu-jitsu black belt, an instructor, and a longtime friend and supporter of Tadede. Through thick and thin, Alan has been by his side, and few know Tadede as well as Alan Santiago.
So Alan, what is special about this intersection?
Yeah, this street is the first job to Tadede.
This is where Tadede worked for his first job.
Yeah. He's a guys to favela, stay here, you know, go to the school, but maybe half escape to the school and come to the street for job to the parking, to the money, you know, but first war, you know, because it's my territory. Hey, Tadede, fuck you, man. This is my territory. Hey, fight every day for the territory. If you win, you a king.
Right.
If you have guys more, you need to walk into the, you know.
Right.
If Tadede give the money, go to the McDonald's.
Right. So people that might not have been here before might not know that parking is really difficult here. There's not a lot of spaces, so guys, little kids will help them park their cars, just like this kid is doing right here. So
yeah.
That was today's first job.
Yeah, now is I have all those boys, you know, living here. Sometimes Tadede put the boys stay parking here. Hey, he's coming to my academy. I give it to your gi. You don't need this. Let's go. Why you don't to school? No, if you training here, you need the school. You know, many boys training to Tadede Academy before working to the parking, but Tadede is changing.
Ele já nasceu com esse carisma. Tadede desde pequeno foi uma criança esperta, ele sempre optou por melhor para ele, entendeu? E várias vezes que nós saímos com ele, eu nem pensava que ele fosse ser é lutador. Eu pensava que ele fosse ser DJ, porque na época do Michael Jackson ele fazia sucesso. E as pessoas pediam para ele dançar na rua, eu levava ele para o médico. Chegava lá, ele começava a dançar, todo mundo gostava e falava, dança aí para a tia ver, eu te dou um dinheiro. E quando eu chegava em casa, ele estava com o bolso cheio de dinheiro que ele ganhava, que as pessoas gostavam e davam. Quer dizer, ele já nasceu com o dom dele, entendeu? Só que eu não pensei que ele fosse ser lutador de jiu-jitsu. Eu pensava que ele fosse ser DJ. Mas na vida da gente, as coisas acontecem, né? E não é por acaso, né?
Being born and living in the favela, how do you feel that that has influenced your jiu-jitsu?
Acho que me dá mais motivação, né? Mais força, mais gana, né? Acho que o fight, a luta, as brigas na rua, na comunidade é desde criança, né? A gente tem essa energia de brigar um com o outro muito cedo, né? Mas sem técnica, né? E depois que eu entrei pro jiu-jitsu, o jiu-jitsu disciplinou muito a minha vida, né? E além disso, me ensinou realmente o que é ser um lutador, que é aprender os verdadeiros golpes. Porque antes eu via o filme do Karate Kid, do Bruce Lee, na televisão, e quando acabava o filme na TV, eu saía na rua já metendo a porrada em todo mundo. Chegava em casa todo sangrando. Acabava o filme, eu chegava ali no portão de casa, uma parada assim, ó. Todo mundo que passava, eu dava o golpe da cobra.
The guys fight for the life, real life. You fight, the boys, the academy, fight for the pleasure, okay? Oh, today not feeling comfortable to training. It's different, understand? The guy in real life, fight, every day fight in the street, in the favela. And when the guy put you, these boys, in this kind of the situation, man, look at this, all the life, understand? Don't change the life. Just now I have some way for to follow. Oh, maybe go now to champion or not, but I like to have like a good life like that. I think this is the way for all the boys there. Oh.
Alan, what do you think is Tererê's biggest strength?
I think Tererê have the special the favela instinct.
The favela instinct.
Yeah, because he's never say what to do. It's just instinct. Mm-hmm.
He moves on instinct.
Yeah, yeah. And Tererê have a heart of the champ.
Mm-hmm. Heart of a champion.
Many, yeah. Many guys is, you know, so good techniques, strong, everything, but the heart, mm-hmm. You know, the heart, the champion.
Right.
You're so tired. I see many times Tererê, the fingers, no grip, mm-hmm. So tired, you know. Hey, Alan, this guy is so strong, man. What do you do? What you gonna do? Man, I can't do the takedown. What you gonna do? Hey, man, take it easy. Mm-hmm. You know.
Right.
Take it easy. Tererê, go to the magic sweep,
right.
And win. Man, I can't believe it.
The Deuce Fight Company. We are people of faith. We are Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belts. We are MMA fighters. But above it all, we are Christians. Many are called. Few are chosen. We are God's warriors. We are the Deuce Fight Company. Visit us online at deucefight.com.
So Tererê grew up in the favela where there was probably a lot of problems growing up. Do you ever see him get scared or intimidated by his opponents in the tournaments?
I think Tererê put in the tournaments all the problems to your life, you know, the food, school, violence, drugs in favela, bad guys. Tererê see everything this, you know. I think is it the Tererê go to the tournament is a focus to the fight, and safe, you know, you
release all your stress.
Yeah, to the difficult life in the tournament.
So his opponent represented all of his
problems. Yeah, yeah. Tererê every time say, hey man, his guy don't have a more problem to me. Uh-huh. He's never win to me because he's have a good life. He's eat milk every day. He's eat many good foods. Sometimes I don't have food in my house, you know. He's don't win to me.
Right. He knew that he was stronger because he had more. He fought more battles.
Yeah. And many times, guys, Tererê see this guy, new gi, many sponsor. Tererê, man, I kill you. Uh-huh. I kill you, man.
Did you feel that jiu-jitsu was easy or difficult when you started?
Pra mim não foi difícil não, porque eu já lutava, né? Eu brincava de luta o tempo todo na rua. Eu lembro que no meu primeiro treino, eu cheguei na academia dando gravata em todo mundo na academia. Eu agarrava no pescoço dos faixa amarela, dos faixa laranja, dando a gravata de porteiro e falava para eles, bate, bate, bate. E eles tinham que bater.
And who did you learn most of your jiu-jitsu from?
Acho que a maioria do meu jiu-jitsu técnico mesmo foi com meu mestre, Alexandre Paiva. E os detalhes técnicos mesmo, assim, muita detalhes de como ser professor, eu peguei com o Fábio Gurgel, em São Paulo, quando eu fui morar lá já na faixa roxa, faixa marrom, né, com 18 anos, 18 para 19 anos, eu fui morar em São Paulo e fiz muita escola de técnica com Fábio Gurgel.
You have a very distinctive style of jiu-jitsu, and now we can see that not only in you, but in a lot of your students. Where did your style of moving come from?
Acho que eu criei, eu por ser, por já ter o sangue de lutador no corpo, né? Por ser lutador de baile funk, por ser lutador de capoeira, eu criei meio que um estilo favela jiu-jitsu, onde eu não parava na frente do adversário, onde eu deixava ele irritado, de não deixar ele tocar no meu kimono, de não parar na frente dele. Isso fazia com que ele perdesse a concentração da luta e abrir esse espaço para eu fazer os meus golpes. Imagine você com raiva no meio da luta e ver o cara sorrir na tua frente. Dava mais raiva ainda nele. Acho que eu fui um dos primeiros a trazer o jiu-jitsu para a favela do Rio de Janeiro. Um dos primeiros meninos da favela a ter oportunidade de conhecer o jiu-jitsu Gracie, a se destacar nas competições. Hoje em dia, na maioria das comunidades do Rio de Janeiro, existe o projeto do jiu-jitsu.
You've competed against some of the best guys in the world, like Nino Schembri, Shaolin, Roger Gracie, Verdum, and Marcelo Garcia. Which match stands out the most in your mind?
Acho que todos os atletas que eu competi, Todos foram pica, entendeu? Todos foram forte, nome forte, né? Eu não tiro mérito de nenhum deles, né? Acho que todos eram os melhores na época deles, entendeu? Então, não colocaria nenhum nome especificamente, assim. Acho que todos eram os melhores, entendeu? Todos eles eram iguais. O lutador, cada um deles, até eu mesmo, foi um dos melhores no seu tempo.
In 2004, you decided to fight three weight classes above your weight, and you fought in the finals against Fabricio Werdum. Why did you decide to fight against such bigger guys?
Eu estava começando a criar um jiu-jitsu de ação e reação. Eu estava mostrando para todos, né, que a formiga poderia ganhar da barata, né? Que o jiu-jitsu é um esporte de equilíbrio, onde não precisava de muita força para você mostrar que você poderia ganhar de uma pessoa mais pesada.
I want to ask about your matches with Marcelo Garcia. How many times did you fight Marcelo?
Eu lutei contra o Marcelo Garcia 4 vezes, né? 3 vezes no Brasil e uma no Japão. As 4 vezes eu consegui vencer ele, né? E as 4 foram umas lutas muito boas para mim, né? Marcelo é um lutador muito conhecido, né? Tem um jiu-jitsu muito bom, né? E além de ser um lutador conhecido e ter um jiu-jitsu bom, ele é meu amigo, entende? Então, além da gente ter essa rivalidade dentro dos ringues, a gente tinha uma amizade, né? Que já treinamos junto antes. Então, lutar contra ele sempre foi um prazer para mim.
The fairy tale of Fernando Tattoday would come to an unfortunate end. Life in the favela is not easy, and the temptations surrounding a life there are numerous. Tattoday was arrested and addicted to drugs.
Your competition career was going really well, and then in 2005 or somewhere around there, you ran into some troubles. What happened?
Tive o problema que todas as pessoas que moram na comunidade pode acontecer na vida deles, né? Pode acontecer na vida da gente. Tive problema com drogas. Nascer aqui na favela é muito difícil. A gente nasce vendo o tráfico desde criança. Infelizmente, eu me esbarrei com as drogas e isso atrasou muito a minha carreira no esporte. Mas agora eu esqueci meu passado e estou vivendo meu presente novamente.
Is it still a battle to stay sober?
Eu acho que a minha batalha contra as drogas é... A droga é meu pior inimigo no momento agora. É o inimigo mais difícil que eu tenho para toda a minha vida. Eu acordo lutando contra isso. Eu tenho que me policiar todos os dias. Eu sei que se eu vacilar, eu posso ser finalizado a qualquer momento. Então eu tenho que tomar cuidado para não recair novamente e passar por toda a dificuldade que eu passei em toda a minha vida nesse momento que eu tive afastado.
Do you feel that jiu-jitsu saved your life?
Eu acho que o jiu-jitsu me salvou, sim. O jiu-jitsu salvou a minha vida, porque eu poderia estar morto junto com meus amigos que morreram antes, né? Morreram mais cedo. Porque nós vivíamos junto, nós estudávamos junto, nós ficávamos na rua junto. Só que eu parti para o esporte e eles partiram para a vida do tráfico. Eles não tiveram a mesma oportunidade que eu tive.
What's the biggest fear in your life right now?
O maior medo que eu tenho agora é me viciar novamente, ser um viciado em droga novamente e parar de trabalhar, parar de ajudar a minha família. Meu maior medo é dar um desgosto, né? Fazer meus pais serem infelizes novamente com as minhas atitudes.
The Favela Jiu-Jitsu Instructional Series by Fernando Tedede, now available in 4 formats, on DVD and on demand exclusively at budovideos.com, and for mobile devices on Google Play and the App Store.
Tedede is a so funny guy, you know, like a comedian. Every day he's showing me new movements, new techniques.
Once he gets the back,